Welcome to Celadon Logistics. Celadon is a world leader in shipping and handling worldwide, with over 280 ships on our fleet. Here at Celadon, we believe in the power of collaboration, innovation, and efficient teamwork. We have over 80,000 hardworking crew members and shipping agents who will proudly welcome you to be a driving force in the logistics industry. So come join us at Celadon, empowering the economy.
Malcolm, this week will be a bit different. Just get the ship running and I'll run you down on the details. Anyways, we've got some big news from Celadon themselves. Apparently we have a special delivery this week. I know this month's been really tough for you, but this is pretty important. You remember those robots from that warehouse? Seems like some company has bought them and wants to take them to their facility. The problem is, their facility is pretty far from here. Although this will definitely frighten you, knowing all the stuff that has happened recently, we are taking huge safety measures with this. First off, you'll be doing this by yourself. The crew members won't be in the ship during voyages, and you'll mostly be in charge of both steering and taking care of the ship. This is all just so we can minimize any danger that comes with delivering, as this is a pretty long journey. Since our regular routine has changed so much, I'll have to reread the instructions on how to handle the ship for you just in case, but I know you obviously know how to handle the ship. I mean, you are the captain, but I've been obligated by staff to do so. So, here we go. In front of you lies the steering wheel. If you hover over the left, middle, or right part of the wheel, you'll be able to move and turn the ship left and right, right up. Ages or a few seconds to understand. By the way, you'll most likely meet a lot of obstacles in the way during your voyages. The weather there is hectic, so be sure you're careful driving around and don't end up smashing into icebergs or seagulls. There are a handful of other things in your cockpit. All the screens monitor certain things. You have a motion detector that scans the whole ship for anything that moves. You have a monitor that keeps track of your distance, and a monitor that keeps track of your water pump and ship integrity. This ship is extremely old, by the way. It'll be decommissioned sometime soon, but it was really the only ship that was available. You'll most likely experience the ship breaking apart from time to time, and stuff tends to malfunction a lot. You're equipped with a ship horn that'll scare any intruders away if they're outside or if there's any incoming obstacles. You also have a water pump lever to your right, which refills your water level if it drains. It seems like the last crew forgot to refill it. Try to use the horn and also refill your water pump by pulling the lever. I know you can do it. Okay, that should be all the instruments you need to learn. In the room behind you, you'll be met with a hall in front of you, and a door on the right, which leads you to the maintenance room. You'll be going to that room a lot, so go in there and I'll explain how it works. This room is cluttered with pipes and whatnot. Whenever a system breaks or a ship's integrity declines, a pipe will burst you. Speaking of which, I guess the last crew didn't make sure to check this room either. Go ahead and fix that pipe that's currently leaking. The room is pitch black, so use your flashlight to see better. Good job. As I said, if anything breaks, just go in here and repair any pipes that start leaking. Alright, you can go back then. I think that should be everything you need to learn. Oh, by the way, you'll be in charge of checking the state of the ship after you've arrived. So, once you're finished, you'll have to stay in the current deck you're in and complete a checklist just to make sure the ship's in good order before leaving. Anyway, I'll leave you alone now. I'll see you when you get there. Hang in there, Malcolm. You're about halfway there, so stay alive for a little bit longer. Alright, the ship is successfully docked and the crew is finishing their shift. First voyage wasn't that awful, eh? Anyways, you'll now have to complete the ship safety checklist. Don't worry, it shouldn't be too hard. The checklist will include all of the tasks you need to complete before leaving. If you're confused as to what to do, the checklist includes a guide just in case. It gets pretty dark in there though, so make sure you aren't wandering in the dark all the time. See you tomorrow. Malcolm, glad to hear you're still in one piece. Celadon took notice of what happened yesterday and decided to do some improvements on the ship. And they wanted me to tell you about it. Don't worry about the last shift, we're all still confused on how one of the robots already managed to escape. We're forced to add a few extra security measures to the ship so this doesn't happen again. Anyways, we managed to install a shower handle at the back hall for the left door. If you go back and check the door, you'll see a yellow handle. We figured that if any of them escape their container again, you can use the handle to temporarily damage the ship. We don't really know if this would cause any permanent damage to the robots, which would lead to a, lawsuit. But it was the cheapest solution we could find. If any of them are outside the door, pull the handle and it'll release water on them, which should hopefully steer them off. Be careful with how long you use the shower handle, as it will drain the amount of water you have left. If that happens, you can refill your water with a lever in your cockpit to the right. Just keep track of your motion detector if any new ones happen to escape the ship. And you should be good. I'll let you know if we've done anything else to your ship. Good luck. There's someone outside the door. Quick, use the shower. You won't be able to see anyone outside that pitch black hall, so use your motion detector. anymore, as everything should be fine for the rest of the voyages. However, we have had some issues with the lower deck. None of the crew members want to go down there for some reason, so I was thinking you could go there after the shift to make sure everything is fine. The ship is starting to run out of fuel, so you're going to have to go down there and refuel the ship too. Anyways, there's been some reports of a lot of weird noises in the vents lately. I'd suggest checking the maintenance room more often if you see anything going on there. And keep an eye on the motion detector. The ship is starting to show its age, I guess. Stay safe. 6 minutes. Take the elevator down to the lower deck. It should be right down the hall. Careful, Malcolm. I'm reporting movement in the lower deck ventilation. Just don't get too close to any of the vents on the ceiling and stay clear of any bursting pipes. read some info from Sonatrix, the company that wants to robot the new facility.
I don't know much about it, but you need to listen. I know everything about the robots. I know where you've been going. I think I know what your subject is.
No.
Please just listen. Those morons. They don't get it. I found something to try. There's some creature that's hiding in the ship. You haven't said anything about it. Only God comes to it, and it's horrifying. It's tall, made of human remains. It all makes sense. And this is what you're fighting. It has some sort of power. It's what's controlling the other robots. But it's extremely dangerous. It doesn't have a name, but I call it the Grok. You don't understand. Killing people. If you do with them, we are doomed. There's nothing you can do. I could just leave. It's over if you don't do anything.
Thank you.
should have told you not to come. I think it knows about a plan. It's been looking for me. I don't know how much time I have left. I'm gonna go disable the lockdown. I'm gonna see myself. This might be the last.
Walking through the ship's interior after hours, looking for my wallet that I dropped on board the ship. While walking in the dark, I found four file boxes that had Marcus Robotics sewing on. I brought these boxes back to the Middle East to where I was wallet. Whoever organized these should be fired. I found Celadon documents and newspapers in a box labeled Marcus Robotics, and oh man, this Marcus Robotics was very funny. And they covered up the death as a strip of murders. And Celadon, the murder at their warehouse was caused by shipping. And they covered it up just so that they could ship that thing for a quick buck and to get it off their hands. When we reach shore, I will release these documents to the press. Who's responsible for the documents?
Thank you.
check the middle deck after the shift. Some of the crew members have been reporting a horrible stench inside one of the storage rooms, and no one has dared to investigate it yet. Make sure the middle deck is closed as well. We came in this morning, the lockdown was disabled. doing. You're making a big mistake. Fine, listen. The news is out. One of the crew members got killed in the storage room. We don't know who did it, but whatever you're doing, please stop. Get out of that ship. Please.
Thank you. I'm convinced that machines can and will think. I don't mean that machines will behave like men. I don't think for a very long time we're going to have a difficult problem distinguishing a man from a robot. But I think that computers will be doing the things that men do when we say they're thinking. I'm convinced that machines can and will think in our life.
Thank you. Yeah.